Heinz Thiel here, reporting from Dixon, Illinois, at World War II Recreated.
All these guys are getting their vehicles and personnel in position. I just want to mention a little bit of who we are. We're all World War II reenactors, not any kind of military group, it's just a history group. And everybody purchases their own uniforms and weapons, and all these vehicles are all privately owned. And again, countless unbelievable amounts of hours to maintain and keep the peace and running.
Thanks for coming to World War II Recreated. Please make your way to the battlefield. We'll get started here in just a few minutes. front of us, you'll see some various equipment that'll be used in battle today. And we'll give you a brief instruction on what these vehicles are. This one right here is quite a rare vehicle, and I'll let the German unit tell us a little bit about that.
Guten Morgen. Ich bin Feldwebel Ernst Jungs, Funk Motorized Company, Großdeutschland, Italien. For the people who don't understand German or couldn't understand my atrocious German accent, what I basically said was, good morning. I am Feldwebel Ernst Humes of the 5th Motorized Company of the Grossdeutschland Division. The Grossdeutschland Division was one of the elite divisions in the German Army. It fought the entire war on the Eastern Front against the Russians, which is one of the reasons our unit decided to pick this particular unit to portray, to put things in kind of a historical perspective for you. Is the American Army had a very difficult challenge when they met the Germans in Western Europe. The Germans had been fighting since 1939. Obviously, you know, D-Day, June 6th was 1944. So the Americans were coming up against a very experienced army. And they had very modern weapons, and they knew how to use them in the field. Some of the equipment that you see here is all original German equipment. The motorcycle that I drove in there is called a DKW 350 NZ-1. It was the 350 cubic inches of displacement. It was the largest single-cylinder motorcycle the Germans made during the war. DKW stands for Das Kleine Werk, which means the small wonder. Some of the other equipment you see here, we have two BMW R71 motorcycles, 750 cubic inches of displacement. And I can't see if the other one is, also the same thing. This vehicle right here is called a Kubelwagen. Okay, that means bucket car in German. It was the basic equivalent of the American Jeep in the German Army. The one major disadvantage it had was not four-wheel drive. What we have on that vehicle is a MG-34 machine gun that is set up on an anti-aircraft mount. This vehicle, as John had mentioned, is a very rare vehicle. In fact, this vehicle is probably the only one of its kind that is running in the world. We know of about 8 other that are in museums in North America. It is a KFW 69 Horch. It was designed to pull this 37 millimeter anti-tank gun and the crew that served it. This particular vehicle was one of the earliest variants of the vehicle that was made during the war. There was 1,100 made, but 250 of the earliest variant were made. This particular vehicle was made by the Ford Motor Company for the German Army just prior to the start of the war. This vehicle dates back to 1939. The anti-tank gun that is being pulled by that vehicle is a 37 millimeter anti-tank gun. That is the same size gun that you see on this focus tank right here. The range on that gun was at about 1,000 meters. It could take out a Sherman tank at maybe 400 meters if they hit it several times. The Germans used that gun throughout the war because it was very mobile and could be easily manhandled by a small crew of men, even though earlier in the war it became obsolete. One of the real challenges that the Americans had was countering the German machine guns. A squad of German soldiers consisted of 10 men. Every 10-man squad had a machine gun with them. That was why their other soldiers were riflemen that used 5-shot bolt-action rifles. So this was very difficult and devastating for the American servicemen to overcome. But how they did that was through superior artillery and the fact that they controlled the air in Western Europe. All right. Thank you, Phil Whipple.